Brothers and sisters, this seasonal change, winter is now in peak of winter we are approaching. And even in the whole creation of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always encourages us to look into the creation and to take lesson from there. He has given us so much nasiha, so much advice for us in the Quran and Sunnah. But also, many of the lessons he put in the creation of him, in the nature. He that said in the surah Al-Baqarah that, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتِ or surah Ali Imran, وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتِ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ فَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. Look at this. Indeed, in the creation of heavens and the earth and the alternation of night and the day are signs for those who are using their sense, their intellect. Those who always remember Allah in all situations when they are standing, they are sitting, or they are lying down. وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ and they think, contemplate, take lesson, ponder upon فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ in the creation of all these. And they are amazed by seeing Allah's power and ability, beauty of the nature, and so much change that the might of Allah is very clear to them. And they say, رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا. Allah, you did not create all these aimlessly. Subhanaka, then in the end they say, Subhanaka, glory to you. فَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. So Allah, you rescue us from the hellfire. You save us from the hellfire. So they relate the nature and changes, cold, winter, everything, and they take lesson. They come to Allah. And their worry they carry always. Even though you go to see the natural beauty in the mountainous area, in the sea, beach, anywhere, you see beautiful garden, you see the zoo, all creation of Allah, you always remember. It's not only amazed by that and be quiet. No, you think. And you ask Allah protection from the hellfire. Don't miss it. Even if you're in holiday mood, we need to ask Allah. So this is the lesson in the creation. And the rihlat ash-shita'i was-sayf journey, the caravan of the journey in the summer and in the winter, the Arabs used to do the shita and saif, two of the main seasons. There are other seasons as well. Two are the main one, which is linked with the sun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it very clear in many of the verses that he changed it. And sometimes because of the sun going to south, coming to north, days and night becoming shorter, night becoming longer, night becoming shorter, day becoming longer, in the summer and winter opposite. This is the creation of Allah. There is lesson here. يُولِجُ اللَّيْلَ فِي النَّهَارِ وَيُولِجُ النَّهَارَ فِي اللَّيْلِ. He causes the night to enter the day, and he causes the day to enter the night. So part of the days go inside the night, and part of the night goes inside the day. How it is possible? Look at the might of Allah, power of Allah, ability of Allah, qudra of Allah. In the nature, we need to learn it. And also the issue of summer and winter. There's a hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to us that اشتكت النار إلى ربها فقالت ربي أكل بعضي بعضا فأذن لها بنفسين نفس في الشتاء ونفس في الصيف فاشتد ما تجدون فأشد ما تجدون في الحر وأشد ما تجدون من الزمهرير. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the hellfire complained to its Lord, to Allah, saying, O my Lord, my different parts eat up each other because of the heat of the Jahannam itself eating part of it. So we have to be, we have to be scared of Jahannam. We have to think about this. If Jahannam itself is complaining about its heat and burning, what about the human being who will be thrown there? How much we're careful of that to save ourselves from hellfire? Qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. How much we are careful. So when they complain, that Jahannam complained to Allah, so then Allah allowed it to take two breeds, one in the winter and other in summer. And this is the reason for the severe heat and the bitter cold you find in winter. So this is one of the lessons from the winter, that this we can see the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also there are many lessons we need to take. Another lesson is from the winter. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraged us that we do spend our time in ibadah during the night time and during the daytime. And day is shorter. Day is shorter. Before that, come to like the preparation for the cold we are making. This is also something good. We need to protect ourselves. There is the cold wave. There is the severe kind of cold could cause harm to us. We need to protect ourselves. That's why we're buying many jackets and all other overcoat, many other things. And this is exactly Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu would like to remind in his time when winter used to come. He'll say, "Inna shita'a qad hadara, wa huwa aduun, fata'ahabu lahu uhbatahu min as-sufi wal-khifaf wal-jawari, sari'un dukhuluhu, ba'idun khurujuhu." He used to say, the shita, that winter came, and it is your enemy. It was like enemy. That means take care of winter, take all this good clothes when you come out, okay? With all this good preparation, you have the socks, you have the, all this jacket, and take all this together. Sari'un dukhuluhu, ba'idun khurujuhu. It comes suddenly, but it going takes place, take time. Slow of going, coming very quickly. So you have to be always ready. Ali radiallahu anhu, similar way, he will say, ittaqu shita fi awwalihi. Be aware of the cold and the winter in its beginning. Beginning is more dangerous. وَتَعَرَّضُ لَهُ فِي آخِرِهِ. In the end, maybe you will be used to of getting some kind of, heat or attack of the cold will be easier to take. But in the beginning, you have to be more careful. يَفْعَلُ بِالْأَجْسَادِ كَمَا يَفْعَلُ بِالْأَشْجَارِ. It does work with the people's body the way it attacks the trees. Trees all leaves are falling. It's a similar way. It attacks the people as well if you are not prepared, not ready. أَوَّلُهُ مُحْرِقْ وَآخِرُهُ مُعَرِّقْ. Its beginning is almost burning. When it's too much cold, it is burning. Look at the plants. Look at the some kind of, vegetables and other things. It's too much heat and too much cold and snowfall. It is like burning. And that's why Jahannam will have burning from the cold as well, zamharir. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to encourage Sahaba to utilize this cold winter for more ibadah. He used to say, "As-sawmu fi shita'i al-ghanimatul barida." Fasting in the winter like is called booty. Like booty is so without buying it, you can get it free. Similar way, the good opportunity of fasting in the winter. That's why many of the Muslims will follow Sunnah fasting in the winter, Monday and Thursday. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to fast regularly. Monday and Thursday, he used to say, these 2 days where our weekly amal is sent to Allah. So I would like to fast the day my amal action will be sent to Allah, that I am fasting. That's why all great predecessors will be doing this. So fasting is one of the good ibadah. Also, there are more beautiful ibadah recommended in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that people used to fast, and he also said many of the Sahaba used to say that fasting, apart from the fasting in the day, in the night time, doing ibadah, qiyamul layl, reciting Quran. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu used to say, marhaban bi shita, tanzilu fihi al-baraka, wa yatulu fihi al-layl lil-qiyam, wa yaqsuru fihi al-naharu lil-siyam. Welcome to the winter. He is very happy when winter comes. More barakah will come in our life. So the days are shorter, easy to fast. And night are longer, easy to do qiyamul layl tahajjud. Ubayd ibn Umair, rahimahullah, the tabi used to say, Ya ahl al-Qur'an, tala alaykum li qira'atikum faqra'u, wa qasura naharukum li siyabikum fasumu. O people of Qur'an, people who would like to have more qiyamul layl, this is your long night, do engage, do utilize it, and your days are shorter, come forward to fast. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also encouraged us. Another ibadah. Ala adullukum ala ma yamhu Allahu bihi al-khataya wa yarfa'u bihi al-darajat. Then he said, qala isbaghul wudu ala al-makarih wa kathratu al-khuta ila al-masajid wa intidaru as-salati ba'da as-salah fadhalikum ar-ribat. He said, should not I direct you to something by which Allah omits the sins and elevates your ranks? They said, yes, O Messenger of Allah. Then he said, performing wudu properly, even in difficulty, especially in the winter time, wudu ghusl is difficult. But for us, probably less difficult because of heating, hot water, all these are available. Remember, in the Arabia, in the hot or in the cold winter, how was the situation? Even the second one, so you do wudu, irtahara, and then frequently going to the masjid in the Fajr, Isha, a bit more cold, come to the Salah, Kasratul Khuta ila al-Masajid, frequently going to the masjid. And the third one, waiting eagerly for the next Salah after a Salah is over. Indeed, that is ribat, that is really guarding the deen of Allah. So, finishing one Salah and waiting for another Salah. And that is coming in the winter, in fact, from Zuhur to Maghrib, very quickly. So, most of the times we are not happy, you are complaining. You can't do anything in the winter day. Only Salah, three Salah, Zuhur, Asr, Maghrib, you are complaining. But this is the opportunity, intizar. You just finished your Jumu'ah, and you'll be waiting how soon you'll be praying Asr. You are eager. And you finish your Asr after an hour or a little bit more, you are coming from Maghrib. So you are not annoyed. You are telling that I am able to, you know, implement this hadith. I'm waiting for another Salah, subhanAllah. We should be happy. We should be happy. So there is barakah more in the winter than we think it is too much complaint, too short day, we can't do anything. So these are the, you know, lessons from the winter, how the Sahaba and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make. And another good ibadah in the winter is to giving more sadaqah. Especially the poor people in this kind of extreme winter weather, do they have enough jacket, overcoat, sweater, jumper, and all these good clothes we have, and heating, and hot water? Do you think the whole world is getting all this? Name we enjoy day and night? Remember all the suffering people, the poor people in many Muslim countries, and the suffering people, the refugees of the Burma. We talked about them last week, the Rohingya Muslims, who were scattered. Some of them are still living on the sea in the boats because the neighboring Muslim country is not allowing them, welcoming them. Neither they can go back to their own country to be killed. Still floating. Is it not cold? Look at the Syria. Situation in Aleppo. Where they are fleeing to jungles, to the tent. There is no hot water, there is no heating. They need some warm clothes. How much we're offering to them? This is the opportunity of winter bringing to us. You can do a lot of reward. We can give, you know, charity to them. Look, giving charity of this kind of needy people, so much rewardful. So much rewardful that one of the Sahabi, or one of the great scholar, was Sufyan, radiallahu anhu, to him a man came. And he asked, Daluni ala Safwan ibn Sulaim, can you show me where I can meet Safwan ibn Sulaim, who was one of the Tabi'een, a great pious among the Tabi'een? I would like to meet Safwan ibn Sulaim. Why? He said, فَإِنِّي رَأَيْتُهُ فِي دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ I have seen him in the dream, he's entering Jannah, paradise. فَقُلْتُ بِأَيِّ شَيْءٍ I asked, who was somebody around me, I asked, what is taking him to Jannah? قَالَ بِقَمِيسٍ كَسَاهُ إِنسَانًا Because of a shirt, or of a top, he has offered to a man. Because of that, he's going to Jannah. He said, I'm very interested. What is the story of this shirt he has given to somebody? You'd like to know the whole story. Then people came to him, asked him, Safwan, what is the story of the shirt? Could you tell us? قَالَ خَرَجْتُ مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ فِي لَيْلَةٍ بَارِدَةٍ One day I came out of the masjid, probably it was Isha and a bit late, and very cold. فَإِذَا رَدُلٌ بِغَيْرِ قَمِيسٍ I found a man, he's very affected by the cold, his body is shaking, there is no shirt for him to wear. Topless, nothing to wear. So I had my only shirt I was wearing, I was also in cold. But فَنَزَعْتُ قَمِيسِ فَكَسَوْتُهُ I took off my shirt and I offered it to him. He didn't know further anything, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shown that guy, because of giving charity this shirt, sacrificing it, took him to Jannah. How many shirts we can give, tell us? We can give more. And it will not affect ourselves. We don't need to lose our one. Allah has given us enough. That's why the spirit of charity should increase in the winter, especially providing winter clothes, warm clothes, blanket. All this to the needy people of Burma and Syria. Whenever appeal comes, please donate generously. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq that we get benefit of the winter, which all is full of wisdom of Allah's creation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us and give us tawfiq. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-azim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayat wa dhikr al-hakim wa aqul qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'il al-muslimin min kulli dhanb fastaghfiru wa atubu ilayhi innahu huwa al-ghafur. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين اما بعد عباد الله اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون واعلموا ان احسن الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الامور محدثاتها وكل محدثه بدعه وكل بدعه ضلاله وكل ضلاله في النار وعليكم بالجماعه فان يد الله مع الجماعه ومن شد شد في النار وصلوا على البشير النذير ان الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد وارض اللهم عن الاربعه الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين الذين قضوا بالحق وبه كانوا يعدلون ابو بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر اصحاب نبيك محمد اجمعين وعن الذين يتبعونهم باحسان الى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك ومنك وكرمك واحسانك يا رب العالمين ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار اللهم انا نجعلك اللهم انا نرجو رحمتك ونخشى عذابك ان عذابك بالكفار ملحق اللهم ارحم عبادك المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم ارحم برحمتك يا رب العالمين اللهم ارحم الاخوان المستضعفين في بورما وفي سوريا وفي سائر بلادك يا رب العالمين اللهم اهلك اعداءك اعداء الدين الذين يحاربون دينك ويقاتلون اولياءك اللهم خذهم اخذ عزيز مقتدر اللهم انزل عليهم باسك الذي لا ترده عن القوم المجرمين عباد الله اتقوا الله واذكروه يذكركم واشكروه يزدكم ولذكر الله اكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون واقم الصلاه